السلام علیکم ورحمت اللہ وبرکاتہ. سو ان دس ویڈیو وی آر گوئنگ ٹو لرن اباؤٹ دا فیل. سو وی آلریڈی نو دیٹ دا ہول عربک لینگویج از میڈ اپ آف تھری تھنگس، اسم، فیل اینڈ حرف. سو وی لرن اباؤٹ اسم اینڈ حرف ان علم النحو سبجیکٹ اینڈ about fail in ilm al-sarf. So this is our first video of ilm al-sarf. In this video, why anyone study ilm al-sarf? What is the need of ilm al-sarf? In ilm al-sarf, we study the complete detail of fail, like how fail is created, how we change fail from one fail to another fail, and how to recognize fail, where at which one is fail, how to make change, how to everything which we need to know about, which we need to learn Arabic language or learn about fail, we will learn everything about fail in ilm al-sarf subject. In ilm al-nahw we learn about ism and harf, and ilm al-sarf we only learn about fail. So this is very actually ilm al-sarf is not quite hard, but it's depend on the teaching method, that how you were taught. There are many techniques to teach the ilm al-sarf. Generally in madaris and Islamic institute, ilm al-sarf, the way the ilm al-sarf is taught by the teachers, quite difficult to understand for a beginners. But inshallah, in this video and in this our course, I'm not just comparing myself that I'm a best teacher or anything. I'm not comparing this madrasa as Islamic institute or like other madrasas, because this is nothing in as compared to them, and I'm nothing as compared to the other teachers of Islamic. So no, but there are some techniques by which if you follow the techniques, then this subject, whole subjects will be we will find out the whole ilm al-sarf. And what we are going to learn in ilm al-sarf will be very interesting, and you will become more excited to learn new things and learn new things about fail. So there is nothing hard, like there are not a lot of differentiate or lot of categorization like ism, like ism in ilm al-nahw which we have learned. But here it's simple, we already learn about fail and different types of fail. So if you understand the rules, and if you understand the technique, how we change the fail, then the ilm al-sarf will be the most easiest subjects you have ever learnt in your whole life. So inshallah, in this video we are going to learn about fail. But for starting, before knowing the fail, it's better for us to learn and understand the terms which we are going to use in the whole ilm al-sarf. And these are the general and the basic terms which is very related to fail. And if I say, then this will not be wrong, that understanding the fail is totally depend on all the terms which we are going to discuss in this video. So it's very important for you to understand the whole terms and memorize the whole terms here. That's why I sent you the notes one day before the video. I hope that you already understand and learn the whole notes as you can. Now I'm going to explain you all the terms and everything by the detail and by giving some examples which will clear you more about everything fail. So ilm al-sarf is a subject where we learn about fail. Fail is a word. Arabic language is made up of three words: ism, fail and harf. Okay, where we learn about ism and harf in ilm al-nahw, and we learn about fail in ilm al-sarf. So here for knowing the fail, we have to know, actually knowing the detail of fail, first we need to understand what is actually fail is. Fail is a single word, give single meaning at a time and having any time period in its translation. There is also ism and fail, we have already learnt in the definition of ism that ism will also have give a single meaning at a time, but it doesn't have any time and period in it. But in case of fail, we have a time period, or we have a time or period in its translation. So what does the time or period stands here? It does either its translation having the translation of past or meaning of past, or anything which will tell that these things happen in past, or translation which will help, which will tell us that this thing is happening in future, in present, or will happen in future. So the meaning of translation, so the translation of fail will be give us the information regarding one of these three. Either the translation of fail will give the meaning that that thing is happened in past, or either this will give the information regarding that that thing is happening now or will happen, or maybe these things will be happen in future. So let me give some examples which will clearly make you understand the whole things which I am trying to make you understand. So here is our digital blackboard, you can say, but it's not a digital blackboard, it's just a MS Word where we am writing something. Okay, so I write here Nasara. So Nasara is a fail. Why I am saying that this is a fail? I am saying Nasara is a fail because Nasara is a single word which is giving a single meaning at a time, and it have a time period in it. And what is the time? What was the time? Is the Nasara translation having past meaning of past? So Nasara mean help. If we say Nasara, this mean help in past. Okay, so here Nasara is giving information that someone help in past. So here is the translation of past included in Nasara. Okay, so this is the time. Either you can add here, you can make some changes in fail to get the answer of present, to get the meaning of present also. Like if I add ya in the starting, you don't have to focus on how I change the Nasara to Yansuru or any other things. We will learn everything in the next video. You have to only focus that you are seeing that the change in fail, or fail having a translation of different times period. If we write here Yansuru, okay, then the translation will be what the translation comes out. Either the translation will be in present or future. For example, Nasara means someone help in past, but when we say Yansuru, this means someone helping now or will help in future. Okay, so you don't have to search for that how we know that if the translation here is present or will future. You will understand more clearly how to find out which translation will here present will be good here or future will be good. We will learn later. You don't have to worry about it. What you have to only focus from all these things that the meaning of fail based on the three times of translation of fail give us a three time period. Either that fail happen in past, okay, or either that fail is happening now in present, or will happen in future. Okay, so this is what I am trying to say by saying that the translation of having any time period in its translation. So if we say somebody help, this somebody help in past, you don't have to say I past. If you say somebody help, this means yes, someone help me. If I write Nasara, Nasara means somebody help in past. If I write here or Yansuru, this means someone is helping now or will help in future. So fail have a single fail is a single meaning, single word giving single meaning at a time and having one of the time period from past, present or future in its translation. Now there are some different types of fail. This will clearly more your confusion and remove lot of your confusion which you might getting now. There are types of fail. We already learned that in here that Nasara is past, but when we add Yansuru, it become present or future. So on the basis of time period, there are some different types of fail. So first one is fele mazi, which will give the translation of past. Other one is fele muzare, which will give the translation of present or future. We will understand later that how to recognize is the translation here is for present or for future, because these two time is totally different. So either the translation will be present or translation will be future. We will later understand that how to recognize is the translation of fele muzare here is in present or in future. What only you have to understand for now is that there are some different types of fail based on time period. So first one is called fele mazi, which give the translation of past. Okay, mazi means time which is completed, or you can simply say the meaning of mazi here is past. Okay, and the other translation here is fele muzare. This is the other types of fail based on translation. So here it's fele muzare. So what will the fele muzare give? Fele muzare will give the translation of present or future. And now the third types of fail here is fele amr. Fele amr is ordering something to do in a positive way. Okay, in fele amr we say someone to do something. Okay, like pray namaz, or pray akimus salat, or saumu ramzan. So we are ordering someone to do something in a positive way, because either that order will be in positive or negative. Either you are saying that someone to do something, so you are ordering that do this, and if you order someone that don't do this, so in the both case you are ordering something. That's why I added here that ordering someone to do something but in a positive way. You don't have to stop someone for doing something by ordering. In fele amr we give order for to do only something, not to stop something from something. And in fele nahi, there is other type of fail here. In fele nahi we give order to stop someone from doing something, or we give here the translation of negative, or we give here the order to stop something in a negative way, like don't do this, don't pray, don't tell lies, don't do something wrong, don't theft, these all types of things. So everything from which we stop someone is fele nahi. And for every fail by which we give someone order to do something is fele amr. So what is fele amr? Fele amr is giving order in a positive way to do something. And what is fele nahi? Fele nahi is giving order to not do something or to not do anything. Either we are stopping anyone from anything, that doesn't matter. For fele nahi we stop someone to do something, and in fele amr we order to someone to do something. So there are four types of fail. First one is fele mazi, which will give the translation of past. Other is the fele muzare, which will give the translation of present and future. And other is the fele amr, where we give someone order to do something in positive way. And fele amr, where we give order to not do something, or we stop someone to do something, that is negative. Okay, now here is a more explanation of fele mazi. Like okay, let me give some examples of all these types. This will clear you. First I'm going to give you the example of first one, that is fele mazi. If this means fele mazi will have a translation of past. Like if I write here zaraba, so zaraba means beat. Okay, so zaraba here is giving the translation of past. What is zaraba here? Zaraba is giving the translation of past. Okay, now for muzare I have to make some changes in zaraba. This is muzare. So muzare will what the translation of muzare we will get the translation of either present or future. Okay, and now, so we have فعل مضارع here, past. We have here it is ماضی, give the translation of past, and مضارع will give the translation of future or present. Now we have فعل امر. Okay, let me write فعل امر from same فعل ضرب to beat. If I write is rib, you don't have to focus how I write is rib. We will learn later how to make فعل امر, فعل مضارع, فعل everything. For now, here it's is rib. Is rib means we are giving order someone to beat, like beat him. So I am saying is rib. Okay, so here this is I am giving someone to do something in a positive. I am saying someone to do. So this is order. This is فعل امر. Amr means in Arabic, Amr means to give someone order. So here I am giving order to beat. Isri means beat. That's why it will give which fail is this? This is fail. Okay. Here it's fail amr, yani means giving order. And other is fail amr. So for fail amr, I'm going to make some changes also. So like this, we write فعل امر لا تضرب. This means here also I am giving order, but I am giving order to stop something. So you can say that to stop. Okay, now so there are the four other types, there are four types of fail, and each one have their other examples here written. I hope you understand the four types of fail more clearly. There it's also already everything is written what we have told you. Same thing is here written in explain. Okay, now there are two type of fail based on happened and it not happened. Like now what means it happened or not happened. For example, if I say, okay, I write here Nasara Zaidun Amran. Okay, you don't have to care about Arab here because you don't know how to insert Arab. You only have to focus on fail here, not on Zaid, not on Am. Here, what does the Nasara Zaidun Amran means? Nasara Zaidun Amran means Zaid help Amr. Okay, so this is a positive. I'm telling that the work of helping is done here. But what if I have to say that Zaid didn't help Amr? So here we have okay, let me first write here Ma Nasara. You don't have to worry about that how I am writing Ma Nasara. Later we will understand everything. Ma Nasara Zaidun Amran. So Ma Nasara Zaidun Amran means Zaid didn't help Amr. So on the first fail, we are telling that something happened. Zaid helped someone. And in other word, we are saying that the work helping is not done. So where the work is done, we say that this fail is positive. Okay? And where fail is not happening or not done or not happen, we say that fail will be fail. That fail will be negative, or what called the positive fail in Arabic, we say that this fail is musbat. Okay, so what does the musbat fail stand for? In musbat fail, some work is done, and in nafi, that is the negative fail, where that fail is any fail is not any work is not happen here. Okay, the fail which come to express or demonstrate that that work is happened is called fail musbat, which is showing that something happened. And the fail which come to show us that thing or that work that didn't happen, that fail will be nafi, fail nafi. So I hope you understand the what is the fail musbat and what is fail nafi. Fail musbat where something is some work is happened, and fail musbat where work is not happened. Okay, for example, I can change the fail also to clearly make you understand. This is the most worst. Okay, let me write Zaraba. Zaraba means beat. So, in the first sentence here, Zaid beats Amr. Okay, and the second sentence, if I change Nasara to Zaraba. So ma zaraba Zaidun Amran means Zaid didn't beat Amr. So first one is positive or musbat fail, and second one is negative, that is nahi, fele nafi. Okay, not fele nahi but nafi, because fele nahi is the other type of fail. It not like fele nahi. Fele nafi is not like fele nahi, because in fele nahi we order to stop someone, and in fele nafi we give information regarding any fail, any work, that that work didn't happen. Okay, now for understanding the other terms of ilmun sarf or fail, we need to understand what is fail. In a single word, in a single word, if I say what is fail, fail is someone who do any kind of work. Okay, who is fail? Fail is a creator of fail. Because of fail, fail occurs. If there is no fail, there will be no fail. Okay, who is fail? Fail is a doer of fail. Okay, fail is responsible for that fail. Because of fail, that fail. You can say anything about fail. Let me clearly you by this example. You already have seen here. Nasara Zaidun means Zaid helps. So helping is a work which is done by Zaid. So Zaid here is fail. Why? Because the work helping, because Zaid did the work help. Okay. So here Zaidun is fail and Nasara is fail. So what is fail? Fail is a ism. Always fail will be always ism. Okay, the file will be, you can always say that file will be fail also. File will not be fail, because fail is different. File will be word. You can say that, what is, if someone say what is file, you can say any word which is responsible for fail or is called file, or a word which express that fail is done by him, that work is done by him, is file. For example, let me clearly you here, Zaidun Zaraba is a fail work, and Zaidun is the doer of that work. Zaidun is responsible for that work. So here, the Zaraba beating is a work which is done by Zaid. So someone who do the work is called fail. Here also, let me give some other examples too. For example, if I say Kataba, okay, Kataba Shahidun. So here, Kataba means write. Okay, so who write? So Shahid is writing. So this means Shahid will be fail, because Shahid is doing the work, that is writing. So Shahid is doing the job, that is writing. Okay, so someone who do the job, do the work, is fail. And what is fail? That work will be fail. I hope you understand the fail and fail. If you didn't understand, you can ask me freely. There is no problem in that. Type of fail based on the availability of fail and fail. Okay, availability of fail. That's why I first explain you what is fail, because the other type of fail is availability of fail. What is mean the availability of fail? For example, here Kataba Shahid. So here Shahid is known. Shahid is written in text, and Kataba is written. So I can say that the work writing is done by Shahid. But what if Shahid is not available? We don't know who write. Okay, we don't know who write. So we so what we can say there? That's why there is a type of different types of fail also, where its file will be available or if file will be not available. Its file will be known or unknown. For example, here the file of that Kataba fail is available. The doer of that Kataba fail is available, but now it's not available. So there are two types of fail in the availability of file. Either the file will be available or file will not be available. So if file is available, we say that this fail is fail ma'roof. Okay, here if file is available of that fail, we say that fail is maruf. This just you see here, Nasara Zaidun. So Zaidun is helping someone. Zaidun helps someone. So here the Nasara work is done by Zaid. So here the file or the doer of that Nasara fail is available. That's why we say that here is Nasara is fail maruf. And when the file is not just like here Nusira, here file is not available. So what is the Nasara Zaidun translation? Translation of Nasara Zaidun means Zaid help. But what is the translation of Nusira? The translation of Nusira is someone help. Okay? Someone help. But here the help, who is the helper is unknown here. We don't know about or it's not available. So when the file is not available, we say that fail is fail majhul. Majhul means unknown. So when the file is not available of that fail, we say that fail is majhul. And when if the file is available, we say that fail is fail maruf. I hope you understand the fail maruf. But now there may be a confusion you can maybe occurs in your brain that the same fail, okay, the same fail, that is Nasara. Nasara here, it's Nasara is maruf. The same fail here, Nasara is becoming musbat, and the same fail here, Nasara is become fail mazi. Only one single word, that is Nasara fail, is becoming three different terms. So yes, these all three different terms comes at a time. Explain this. Let me write. Okay, I'm going to take another ism, that is dakhala, because we have to understand, we have to increase our vocabulary of Arabic. So dakhala means enter. Okay, so dakhala means enter. So dakhala is fele mazi. Why? Because it gives the translation of past. You don't have to understand now how I recognize. We will learn later. So dakhala is here fele mazi. So what is dakhala here? Just follow me. Dakhala is fele mazi. So the categorization of mazi, why it's fail mazi? Because it's the categorization of fail based on time period. So according to time period, dakhala is fail mazi. Okay, so dakhala is a fail mazi because of giving a translation of past. Okay, now dakhala is fail musbat. Fail musbat. Why dakhala is fail musbat? Dakhala is fail musbat. Dakhala is fail mazi according to the categorization of time, and dakhala is here fail musbat because it's telling me that someone enter. It's not telling me that the work entering is not happened. The dakhala is telling us that the work entering is happened. That's why this is fail musbat. So according the happen and not happen categorization, here dakhala is telling that fail is happening. That's why it is fail musbat. So same dakhala is fail mazi, and dakhala is fail musbat, and dakhala is fail maruf. Okay, fail maruf. So you can say that, you will say that I didn't write then the file here for fail maruf. We have to write the doer of ism. Okay, so don't worry. This will create a lot of confusion. So okay, let me write here that. So here dakhala is fail maruf. Why dakhala is fail maruf? Because its file is available here. Okay, so the same dakhala fail is three. Fele mazi, dakhala is fele mazi, dakhala is fele musbat, and dakhala is fele maruf. Okay, let me, I hope you understand all, because these all things, the fele maruf is a categorization of fail based on the availability of file, okay, and fele musbat is based on the positive and negative of that fail, and fele mazi is the categorization based on the time and period in which time that fail is happened. Okay, so there are the three different kinds of categorization of the fail. So it's possible, and it's not only possible, it is necessary to become a fail having these three types of categorization in it. So for now, I hope I try my hard and best to make you understand all the terms which we are going to use in this fail. In this book. Is there anything which I had to explain, or is there anything that you didn't understand? So you can ask me. For the next video, inshallah, we will start fele mazi from first. We will start from fele mazi. If there is fele mazi, then we have to take one categorization from here. So we will start from fele mazi, which is fele musbat also, and which is fele maruf also. So in next video we will learn about fele mazi, which is fele, which will be maruf, that is its file is available, and which is which gives the translation that fail happen, any positive, and which will happen in past. So inshallah, in next video we will learn about everything about fele mazi. So for now, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.